Good evening. Today I'm going to present on assessment of bleb functioning using morphology, gonioscopy and ultrabiomicroscopy. We all know that trabeculectomy is a gold standard surgical management of glaucoma, and development of bleb is crucial for the long-term surgical success. So the aim of our study was assessment of bleb functioning using Wurzburg bleb classification score for bleb morphology, gonioscopy and ultrabiomicroscopy, and finding the cause of failure. The primary objective was to find the correlation between the IOP and bleb morphology and its association with the gonioscopy and the UBM. The secondary objective was to find the correlation between the IOP and the duration of surgery. The study was a cross-sectional observational study of 50 eyes. After thorough ophthalmological workup, the bleb morphology, gonioscopy and UBM were all compared with the IOP, and the IOP targets were set between three groups: group A with IOP less than 10, group B IOP 10 to 21, and group 3 more than 21. The results were analyzed, and on assessment of bleb with the WBC score, we found that the four criteria, that is the vascularity, the corkscrew vessels, the encapsulation and microcysts, all were significantly associated with the IOP. The correlation of WBC score with overall IOP range was negative, which was significantly associated. Here is the picture with a bad and a good bleb. On assessment of bleb with gonioscopy, we found that the peripheral iridectomy and the inner ostium were significantly associated. In the 9 patients where the inner ostium could not be seen, we found that either the iris had fallen back, or there were fibrosis, or there was vitreous in the inner ostium, or it could not be visualized. On assessment of bleb with the UBM, we found that the root under the flap and the scleral reflectivity both were significantly associated. Here is the picture of good bleb, a fair bleb and a poor bleb. Overall comparison of the three with IOP, we can see that in all the 7 patients where the IOP had increased, the WBC score was always on the poor side. The PI and the inner ostium were either present or absent, but in our study, their presence was significant. UBM was either good or poor, but it was never good. And seeing the duration, we can see that the duration was not at all related with the IOP. The cause of the failure was hence seen and rectified. So all of us, whatever we found in our study, were all concluded differently in different studies. But what was different in our study was that we compared all the three all together with the IOP for the assessment. To conclude, the trio is a great boon for the trabeculectomy function. IOP is negatively correlated to WBC score. The duration of IOP is not correlated. The presence of patent peripheral iridectomy and patent inner ostium are important for the long-term functioning of bleb. More microcysts and less vascularization better the agreement of reaching target pressure. Bleb morphology also helps in predicting the IOP. UBM can be used for predicting anatomical results post-trabeculectomy. On UBM, the scleral reflectivity and root under the flap are significantly correlated in predicting the outcome and to appreciate the aqueous humor drainage in the living eye. In patients where gonioscopy and slit lamp was not conclusive, the cause of failure was hence assessed with the help of UBM. Coming on to practical implications, the trio is a part of routine ophthalmological examination and is of great benefit for setups where ASOCT is not there. In majority of the patient, the cause of failing bleb can be determined and hence rectified, and these methods are also cost effective for the patient. Thank you.
Can you show your previous slide, please?
Which one?
Good presentation. Yeah, this presence of patent peripheral iridectomy and patent inner ostium are not only for long term. If it's not patent on day one only, it won't function. It has
sir,
to be patent.
Yes, sir. Patent peripheral iridectomy and patent inner ostium are very important for the long-term functioning of the bleb. But yes, it is very important as...
On day one itself. If it's not patent, it won't function.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So next time you can remove that point.
Yes, sir. Actually, patent peripheral iridectomy, actually in many studies that it has been found that the presence of PI
iris
is
pillars.
Not important. In both with the help with and without PI, the results were all the same. But yes, peripheral patent inner ostium is definitely the crux of the surgery.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.